Welcome to the GIS Applications in Civil Engineering class at UNLV. Although during the lectures and lab exercises you will be learning a lot of material about GIS and the software used to perform GIS, but these tutorials are created to supplement that and help provide additional material that would help in better understanding of the material covered in this class. This first tutorial explains how to start the ArcMap program and describes the basic interface information of the desktop. To start the program, find ArcGIS in all programs. Here you will see a couple of applications: ArcCatalog, ArcGlobe, ArcMap, ArcReader, ArcScene. These are different programs provided by ArcGIS package, and they have their own functions. In this first tutorial, we'll learn about ArcMap. Once ArcMap starts, notice a couple of things on the desktop. The menu and the toolbar are very generic, just like any other typical Windows program. But the desktop has two main components. On the left side, the box is called Table of Contents, whereas the right box is called the Main Map Area. The layers added to a map are listed in the Table of Contents, and this is where we can turn them on so that they are displayed in the map area. For example, consider this map of United States. If you look in the table of contents, we have three layers. The layer states is checked and appears in the map area, whereas the layers Las Vegas boundary and Las Vegas zip codes are unchecked, and they are not, you cannot see them in the map area. Now, for example, if I check the boundary, you can see it. Let's zoom in. We will talk about the zoom toolbar later on. Once we zoom in, you can see the Las Vegas boundary. And when I turn zip codes, notice how the zip codes appear, but the Las Vegas boundary has disappeared. This is because the order of the appearance of these layers follows the way they are listed in the table of contents. In order to bring the Las Vegas boundary to the top, we can click and drag the zip codes below it, and notice how the Las Vegas boundary comes to the top. Okay, I think that's enough for the first introductory tutorial. We'll talk about how to add new layers into the table of contents in the next tutorial.